Hello everyone, this is part 13 of my Byzantium Civilization 5 game. Remember to check out part 1 if you want to know what mods and so on that I'm using. So, where things stand right now, I have influential status with 2 out of 9 of my opponents. It was actually 1 out of 8, but somebody resurrected another civilization. Okay. Right. So I'm trying to fill out aesthetics here. Because that gets me able to purchase writers, artists, and musicians with faith, and also doubles the theming bonus from museums and so on. So the problem I'm going to have here for a cultural victory is the cultural strength of Poland. I'm going to need to either pick a war or get a whole army of great musicians to conduct concert tours, or I'm not going to actually make it. That said, I've thought that in previous games, and then along the way, suddenly it just hit a breakover point, and I managed to pull out a victory, a cultural victory. Something I've noticed is that when you're playing on a huge map, the victory you almost always end up getting is cultural. It's really difficult to do a conquest type victory just because of the vast distances involved. And by the time you manage to get up enough of an army that you can go and start taking original capitals, it becomes difficult to, basically to keep the supply lines and so on working, and to actually defend those capitals when you do take them. Okay, so my broadcast tower increases culture. That does seem like a good option, though the stadium will improve happiness, and I am having a little bit of trouble with that, so I think it'd be a good idea to actually build stadiums. So the broadcast tower is also definitely a good idea. At some point, I'll be able to start setting my settlers to building a railroad network. And that will substantially improve production, because there's a production bonus to cities that happen to be connected to the capital with a railroad. Meanwhile, I'll just keep on improving the tiles around my other cities. Just, you know, most cases it's going to be pointless. But it does mean that if the city wants to use that tile, it's already improved. Okay, so that was enough to get influential with somebody. Polynesia, apparently. And that gets me up to 59,000 with Poland. I've got a rising slowly on there now, which it was actually falling before. So this recent increase in tourism apparently has helped. Yeah, there we go. It was definitely Polynesia. Right. Okay, that's another. So I'm improving there. That's done. That isn't yet. Okay. I think I'm definitely going to build a mine there. Okay, what? That's a temple. I do have a fair bit of river land here, so I think a hydro plant would actually be worth doing here before I get too far along with other things. Then again, well, I'll do that. Right. Again, I have a lot of river land for this city, so a hydro plant would be useful, but I'm going to get my faith buildings and culture buildings out. Okay, so that's a temple there. Right. Well, a museum would be a good idea. Okay, yeah, a mine there. Okay, so I built a mine there, and I've got a mine there. So there really isn't much else in range of a city up here that is going to give me any real benefits to improving it. The only thing you can actually build on the snow is trading posts, which basically give you gold, and that's about it. Yeah, this one isn't actually in range, so definitely. So I could go ahead and do that, or I could actually, I've got a tile there that's in range. Temple. Culture buildings. Oh. It's my turn again. Well, I'm going to get a social policy real soon here. Well, it says 13 turns, but that's real soon on a marathon game pace. Oh! I need to go and fix my influence level there. What is this? That's a forest tundra. Well, in that case, a lumber mill is the best choice. Let's see. That's a stadium. broadcast tower for the culture. And here, well, build the temple, and I suspect then the aqueduct. And I need to bribe these guys. So that'll get me a few turns there. That's okay. You know, I'll get these guys back as well. Since I've actually got a decent level of gold production underway now. So that gives me three city-state allies. So the next era, that means I'll have six extra delegates over the base number. That won't be enough to beat Poland, but... Right, that's a broadcast tower. I don't have much else to build in here at the moment. I need a university still there. And I need two opera houses. Okay. Well... I'll switch up to wealth there. Golden Age is going to end, so that's going to slow down my gold and culture and so on a little bit. There we go. That just doesn't seem like a sensible war to get into. Statue of Liberty. That's Porcelain Tower. What do you need for the Statue of Liberty? Right. What do you need for it? Huh. In that case, I'm just going to look that up. Wonders. Statue of Liberty requires replaceable parts. One free social policy. Right. So in that case, I think I want to put my cities with nothing better to do on research. Now, am I aiming for replaceable parts? I'm not. Which one? Okay, I'm researching that one. Then I'm gonna go there and then for railroad. Maybe I'll get it in time that I can rush the Statue of Liberty. Right. Yeah, I finished a temple. Okay, I'll build the opera house there. And I'm working on a seaport there. So when that seaport completes, then I'll be able to. Switch that over to something more useful. What was that? Oh, my faith. Wild. One, two, three. Okay, that one's in range. A great scientist would be really useful right now, but I would have to fill out rationalism to get that with faith. Okay, so that's the iron connected there. Okay. Now there really isn't anything else in reach of Orid there. So for lack of anything better to do, I'll go up here and set the guys making trading posts. Right. Switch this back to food to Constantinople. Okay. I've basically covered everything over there. There's really nothing else to build over there. Okay. In that case, I'll send the worker out that way. Right. Well, there isn't much else doing there. Right. That was a temple. Guess I'll go for a museum there. Okay. So I'm going to have a whole army of workers building trading posts on the snow there, by the look of it. Right, so more broadcast towers, more trading posts. This is really like there's really not much point to it, but there's nothing else doing, so I might as well. Saves me having to recreate the workers when I do need them. So it looks like 13 turns for the seaport there in Cherson, however you pronounce that. Okay, that's steam power. Yeah, there's nothing else doing there, so. You get the workers out there. Who knows, if I manage to get those cities up to a decent size, I'll get the gold production off those trading posts. And that might be worth it there. Okay, so 20 turns for replaceable parts. What would be useful is a great scientist. Wonder how long off one is. I can check that. Artists, engineers, merchants, musicians, scientists. 3 turns! Huh! Okay, that's a camp there. Nothing else there in range again. I expect I'm going to be seeing the new era on the World Congress real soon now. Okay, Huns went for freedom as well. Actually, I'm going to check in here on Constantinople and see what's doing here. So I've got 69 surplus food. Market and the bank and the stock exchange are not actually being worked by specialists. I expect that will change as the city grows. Oh, this is an interesting offer. He's offering to fight with Attila. I'm going to agree to it, but I'm going to take the time to prepare. There's my great scientist. Okay, I've got a policy I can adopt. Let's look at that. Okay, that gets me a great artist. And this gets me an immediate golden age. That's the one I want. That's increased culture immediately. Right. That's actually quite good. And the great scientist, I'll bulb him. That gets me replaceable parts. Then over here, I can change this to Statue of Liberty. Hurry it. Right. This guy needs work to do. Send him up. Okay, so I've got me a golden age. I've got increased culture from from policy there. What's the culture generation here look like? Right. I'll take the gold from the Huns for as many turns as it's practical. Okay, I'll take my free social policy. Right, I just need to reset here. And my free policy will be getting a great artist. Which I will use to extend my golden age. You'll notice that that's stacked with the previous one. And my production here. So a military base is defensive. That could be worth building. But what am I looking at here? I'm going to build a couple of cannons. Even though I do actually have enough, going to upgrade a couple of these units here as well. Okay, so I have all of my workers just about are well away from the Huns. Okay. Okay, so I outright lied to him about my units just passing through. Okay. So that was a broadcast tower. Well, since I can't afford to upgrade units, I might as well build them. Okay, so that's a museum there. I think the broadcast tower might be a good choice there. Ah, the artillery will be nice. That's the range 3-1, and it can fire over obstacles as long as the target can be seen. Okay, nothing else doing there. So I'll send this guy away up here. Park that guy. Right, nope, that can't be upgraded any further, so there's that. So that's the opera house there. I think I'm going to need the gold production soon here. Let's see. Yeah, broadcast tower. Oh, nice. One of the infantry I upgraded has the double attack. Oh, I've got... Still in the lead for wonders, go figure. Right. Right, this is the city that he sued for peace to protect last war. Ah. Somehow I think if I'm going to build units there, military academy would be a good idea. Okay, there's my seaport there. So I'll now start catching up on the other stuff. Get a university there and then get an opera house there. And I think that gets me those two national wonders that I've not got yet. Okay, broadcast tower or hydro plant? Broadcast tower. So I'm going to start upgrading my units along my frontier there. As it becomes possible to do, resource wise. Okay, so over here, upgrade this one. No. I'll let him keep his iron. I'll let him keep his iron. And I'll let him keep his iron. Same for her. Oh, right. So I should be able to do some real damage real quickly here. What's the cost to upgrade to cavalry? That's quite high. What's the cost here to upgrade to a cannon? Not bad. Okay, declare war. Which city states? Okay. Okay, so that's a market there. Go for a bank. Okay. Now I need to do my war thing. Oh, that's where I got bombarded from. Okay. Okay. Oh, St. Ives is going to be a bugger to take if I do choose to. Definitely want to take out his units more than anything. Okay, so that's over that way. Now I need to move my units in here. Let's see. Okay, right. The cannon, I'm going to have to come down around this way with, so it can see. Same with this one. Right. Right, so there's forests around there. So that's quite a good defense against cannons. Right. So, we'll see what happens here. Since this city isn't actually garrisoned at all, it only has one attack. What unit was killed? Come on, show me. Ah, dynamite. Ah, I see. Okay. Yeah, I kind of expected to lose that one. Right, I'll attack there. I'll attack there. A great person! Woohoo! Oh, attack there. Yeah, that wasn't so smart. That's right, they're not good for city attacks. Anyway, that should be the one that I lose. Right. Just go around collecting his civilians. I think that seems like a sensible thing to do. And actually seeing his land layout. Right. Well, I'll actually do some melee attacks against the city here. Ah, I think it would be good to bring in always with the resetting of those trade routes. Okay. And this cannon here. Right, so I finished a military academy. Don't have anything else to build there, really. So I'll work on infantries. Since they're reasonably good for city attacks, actually. Melee attacks on cities. Okay, that'll do. One thing this war does is it gives me something to do while I'm tooling around here. Right. Oh, that's just has a range of two, right? That's not a artillery range 3. Right. So I have to bring it in range and set up to do that. Right. Okay, that's Saint Ives is down substantially there. Right, I'll send this worker up here. This one too. Okay. Wait a minute. What am I? So I built a Great War Infantry. Build some more of those. Promote. So I'll send that infantry over there. One, two. Send that guy over there. This guy can go over here. And do the pillaging. Okay, so I'll attack the city. Okay. Right. There's a cannon there. Okay. There's a good chance I'm going to pick up that city next turn. What unit was killed? Ah, over by St. Ives. Okay. Attack. Set up. Attack. Attack that cannon. There is a risk that you might want to avoid when you pillage. Actually, there we go. I'm going to create a puppet city. Right. So I'll let that unit heal. Take a pot shot there. This one is the one with the nice promotions. Right, and St. Ives. Okay. There we go. And there's St. Ives. Okay, now that I've taken two cities there, well, let's just finish this stuff here. Build the university there. Yeah, that was the broadcast tower there. Well, I might as well build the military base. And what I want to check is whether there's any, there weren't any great works in either of those cities. So there's none that I need to move around. Right. Okay. Moving along. I'll send my general over there. Right. Now we'll see what happens. It's possible the Huns will sue for peace now. Okay, so nice that they did not sue for peace. Okay. Well, in that case, I will keep at it. 1, 2, 3, that is in range. Right. I'll let that heal. I'm going to let all of my units here heal. Actually, I'm going to take out that cannon first. That would be the thing to do. Then let the units heal. Now, who to attack? Damascus might be a good one to attack. That's in neutral territory, right? It is. Okay. Oh, that's a worker. Well, having taken this St. Ives, I've got some terrain in range that I can improve. I definitely need that guy to Right. So I'm probably going to lose the artillery there. But that's fine. These city connections actually improved the happiness substantially. So that was nice. I'm going to have a World Congress vote next turn here. Okay. I need to move this guy. Back. Now, let's deal with the World Congress first here. Cultural heritage sites are fine. But I do not want a ban on whales. Okay, so commit delegates. Now, what can I do? Okay, first of all, I'll whack here, and take the city. That's how I save my artillery there. Okay. There were no great works there either. So far, so good. Barbarians? Wow. Right. Okay, one, two, three. Actually, there. Right. Oh, I can't actually see the city there. Now I can. Okay, so far so good. Okay, what's he offering? No. That's not the right offer. Right, so I'm gonna end up. Oh, Poland took Damascus. Okay. Varna is starving. Why? Oh, probably because it's unhappy in the Empire. Okay. Right. Okay. Okay, that's an attack there. That's an attack there. Rifleman. Might as well park that one in the city there. That is forest grassland. I'll make a farm there. Okay. Attack the cannon there. Okay, I'll give it one more turn here. She's offering gold. Yes, that will do. Okay, so I lost me a cannon. Oh well. Right. So I'll take some pot shots at the city here. And take an attack there, an attack there, and bam. Now, raising the cities would be probably smart from the perspective of the sprawl effect, especially the chilling effect on science. But it also means I can't look in the city to see if there's great works to relocate either, which is something that I will be doing here. Now, I'm not going to be going out of my way to conquer more cities, I don't think. Mostly because I need to fix the happiness issue in my empire first. But that has significantly curtailed the Huns. I've taken what, one, two, three, four cities here in this war. So I'm currently using more coal than I have. Oh well. Okay. Right. Think I'll park my units over by the Hunnic capital now. Let that one heal. Marble, huh? Nice. Right. What city here? Right, over here. Okay. Start upgrading my units here, I think would be a good idea. Production here. I might as well just build me a military base there. Right. Wait, I can improve my happiness a bit, I think, by garrisoning these cities. Right. Like this one. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Okay, so after this turn settles here, I'm going to call this a part. I could easily get mired in the intricacies of the war and lose track of time. Okay, let that unit heal. Send that guy over there. Right. Send this guy over here. Right. So I'll pillage and fortify. I'll whack at the city there. What I'm trying to do is convince the Huns to sue for peace, and in so doing, offer me a city. Or two or three, which could happen. Okay, I have a happiness issue, so I should build the happiness buildings. Where has this? Oh, it's a worker. Well, workers aren't that big of an issue. Okay. Well, what I can do here is I'll upgrade that guy and then I'll send him after this camp here. If I remember. Anyway, that's going to be the end of part 13. So I'll see everybody back for part 14.